Tramp. Does anybody actually know what tramping is? The tramp is
like when you're in the gutter in New York or something.
Not quite. Yeah. Now, tramping is actually a very old school term for kind of akin to backpacking nowadays. Tramping was just for if you were going to be moving under your own, like, power of your own legs and carrying your load on your back or across the tump line or something like that, where the load was completely on you and you were just moving over land by walking. That's what tramping actually was. So, like, you might have guys that set up a deer camp, and that deer camp, you know, might be there for 2 weeks, but one guy might leave for 2-3 days by himself and everything just to go off over the next ridge and try and see what he couldn't get. So he would then take all the gear that he needed for that time with him and go tramping off on his own. So that's where the term comes from, right? So we want to make a distinguishment between tramping and cooking, like camping, excuse me, tramping and camping, because camping generally is where you're going to be base camped in one spot, where you're just going to be either driving there or getting there by horse or conveyance somehow, and camping is one spot, so your gear is not on your back or on your person. As far as for tramping gear, though, I wanted to go over with you guys some basic options that you have as far as gear, and I wanted to also go along with some options that are practically free that you probably have around your house already that you can go ahead and kind of make on your own. That way you can save some money, and it's usually actually lighter gear than what you can buy at the store, right? So, food or water, which one's more important?
Water.
Right? So water's more important. So, you have a basic canteen. This right here is about a 1 gallon canteen, and you can find those in any thrift store, or usually old camping stores and anything. You can find this in the plastic box, right? So, the whole thing's not metal. It's only plastic on the sides with metal outer. If you want one that is solid metal, you can usually find those in antique stores. It usually costs anywhere from $10 to $30. If they're $30, then no, just wait for the $10 one to pop up. But if you're tight on cash or just really just don't want to go hunt for one or anything, I just have a gold tea jug here. It's a little tougher than your basic milk jug. Just tie a string on that. That'll hang on you just fine. When we were working wilderness therapy, stuff like this, guides were using stuff like this, and they were using it for years. No problems with it. Didn't cost them a thing. So that is still very good. Also, if you don't want to purchase like a metal water bottle or like one of the nice Nalgene that you see everybody with and everything, this was 99 cents. Drank what was in it. Good to go if I have two of these. And I have a way to purify the water, be it pump, tablets, anything like that. Or if I have like a metal cup with me that I can boil in, this will hold my water just fine for a trip. And it's 99 cents in the store, or you probably have one in the trash can at home. To store-bought items and everything, metal water bottles. I do recommend metal water bottles, mainly because you can boil in them, and you don't necessarily have to transfer it from cup to, you know, your other water bottle. You just boil the water right there, and it's already housed. Very nice for that. They are a bit more resilient than this. You can also use, a lot of people like the old-school glass water bottles just for a traditional sense. These are fine and work really well. Don't set them anywhere on your backpack or anything that when you drop it, they're going to shatter. You will never get all the glass out of your backpack. There will be remnants in there. I give this out because I've done this, and I threw away a backpack because I could not get all the glass. Every time I reached down the bottom of the pack, I'd get like little pieces embedded in my fingers. But yes, metal water bottles are great. I recommend on the metal ones, get a larger size than the ones that you generally find at the thrift store. The small ones generally don't hold enough water to actually like keep you sustained for a long trip. Metal ones with a smaller mouth are really nice because if you like to hang your stuff like I do, if you take a pair of fish mouth openers, you can actually just kind of stick them right there and it'll hang your pot. So that one works really well. And that kind of gives you a little bit more options as far as cooking multiple things on a smaller fire. A lot of people like the camelbacks and everything. Nothing wrong with camelbacks. A lot of modern backpacks nowadays have slots for the bladders themselves. I recommend if you're going to go that route and use the bladder in the backpack, still take the sleeve that fits the bladder. That way you don't have to take your backpack every single day if you like get to a resting point and then you want to go explore the area or something like that. You don't have to take the entire backpack with you and take the water source. So those are really nice. These especially you must clean out. I know a lot of people have gotten sick by not cleaning them out. And if you ever put anything in there that's not water, then buy a new bag, pretty much, because you're never going to get it fully clean. Whatever you had in there, the taste is just going to be in there. It's just how that was kind of go. So those are just kind of like your options for water, right? So let's move on to food. So for food and everything, you do have a couple different options. Obviously, we can make a fire and we can cook over the fire. That's what I prefer, and I think the ambiance is nice, but we do live in Utah, especially with all the wildfires recently. We do have some fire bans. And so we want to be sure that we know that we can have fires in the area, and if we can't, but we still want to go to the area, well, we need a stove or some way to contain a fire or something that is more propane or butane based, right? So for that and everything, this is your most common type of modern stove. Everything, you can buy these little cylinders, Walmart, camping stores, anywhere, they range anywhere. I've seen them $4.99, I've seen them up to $10.99, just depending on what type of fuel it is. These are nice, they last quite a while. When I was working for Spiro, one of these would last you for a week. So they do work for quite a while. These are your Sterno type of stove. All you do is pop the top, light a match, throw it in, and it's good. So you usually get about three burns out of it. Save the lid on them, you can put the flame out, put it back on, you can light it again. So those are great. And then you have what we're going to make today. This is a penny stove that I'm going to hand around for you guys. Today. That stove runs on 90% or more rubbing alcohol or heat, like antifreeze, like you put in your car. That's what I brought for fuel today. For those of you who want to make one today, works great with heat, and a single bottle of heat runs that thing about four times. So a single bottle of heat, you can get a four pack for $4.99 at the store. I know because I bought one the other day. So that's what, 16 burns off of $4.99, and those are free to make. Did anybody see any of the videos that I put up on making stoves, making hobo stoves? Mm-hmm. A couple of you guys did. So this is just a stove from that. We also have cans today if anybody would like to try their hands at making these. These are generally just called hobo stoves. They're really easy to make. And it's nice if you still want the fire. Still want that kind of ambiance of the fire, you still want to warm your hands over the top of it. Those are really nice for that. They burn down to white ash, and when that white ash is dead ash, you can just take that and you can just throw that on bushes around, and for the state of Utah, that counts as LNT, leave no trace. So that is a good option if you don't want to make a penny stove, or if you still want the ambiance of the fire, that one works out really, really well. And a lot of people would just get by with one of these. There's nothing wrong with that. If you want to go a little bit more money, those are usually $5 for $10. I got this at Walmart a little over a year ago. And this thing has been beautiful for me. It's just a larger brush pot. Came with the handles. I added a bale and so I can hang it. And these work fantastic. It comes with the lid. You can bake in these now because it has the lid. And you can cook larger meals that you may not be able to cook with that. I need a lot of energy on the trail. Some people may not. It just kind of depends on where you're at. If you don't want to spend any money, though, and you're a coffee drinker, then you have coffee tins. Right? If you have a wire hanger, you can put a bale on that so you can still hang it. Or, if you want, you can tie it to a bedroll, such as the one over there, just kind of hang it on the end of a tomahawk or tie it to the bedroll, or just set it right down in your backpack. One thing I do like to stress, though, with any kind of a larger pot like this, don't waste the space in your backpack or anything like that. So with a larger pot and everything, for this one, I can fit dehydrated milk, granola, noodles, and cheese to make the noodles for the mac and cheese and all that. I can fit all that down in it already. And that's 4 days worth of breakfast and dinner. If I throw a couple protein bars in my pocket, I'm good to go. I've got 4 days worth of food right there for the trail, and that's all just in the same one container. I'm not taking up more space in my backpack. So
do you keep the lid?
Yeah, I keep the lid, so that way it seals up. Because then at night, I can put all of this back in here, and I can hang this in a tree, and this now becomes my bear bag. So I don't have even my cooking gear bringing in animals to my camp and are curious just because it smells.